comment, but a government official familiar with the case says yes, they are connected, and her target was Lars Vilks, the Swedish cartoonist. Back in 2007, he made some cartoons with the head of Muhammad on the body of a dog. As you know, dogs are highly offensive to conservative Muslims. Many Muslims took offense at this, and reports are that Al-Qaeda put a price on his head at that point in time. So Vilks apparently the target here.
And Peter, let me bring you in here. This is obviously another very disturbing example of the evolving face of terrorism. And what do you make of this increasingly prominent role that women now play in the jihadist movement?
Campbell, I think certainly this is the first case I can think of an American woman who's converted to Islam, who's really got involved in the jihadi cause, or allegedly so. We've had European Catholic converts to Islam. A woman called Muriel de Gore conducted a suicide attack in Iraq in 2005 against an American convoy, but it's pretty unusual. The women that we've seen attracted to Al-Qaeda's cause in the past have tended to come from Pakistani American backgrounds. They haven't been converts as this woman is. But another thing that I think it leaps out here, Campbell, is this is the second case of an American citizen planning to kill a cartoonist involved in these Prophet Muhammad cartoons. You may recall a Chicago citizen by the name of David Headley cased the Danish newspaper where a cartoon of the Prophet Muhammad had been made that a lot of Muslims found offensive, and he actually traveled to Denmark to try and scope out the murder of this Danish cartoonist. So now we have two Americans, and part of the thing that's disturbing here, I think, is that, you know, we used to be concerned about Americans, you know, in the United States, of jihad coming to the United States. Here you have Americans who are allegedly trying to export the jihad overseas.
All right, we got to end it there. Peter Bergen, Gene Meserve, many thanks. Appreciate it.